conflict was between three main ethnic groups, the Serbs, the Croats, and the Muslims, and it resulted in genocide committed by the Serbs against the Muslims. Okay. The Serbs made up 32% of the population, and so therefore they were a minority. And in the late 1980s, a Serbian leader named Slobodan Milosevic arose, who created religious hatred between ethnic groups to gain power. He began by inflaming long-standing tensions between Serbs and Muslims. Milosevic first attacked Croatia, a Catholic country where Serbs made up 12% of the population. Then, with the help of Serbian fighters in Croatia, Milosevic attacked the Muslims to protect the Serbian minority. With the rising tension, the UN declared six safe zones for Muslims, the most well-known being Srebrenica.
So can you just point out on the map where these places are? So point out where the three main ethnic groups are.
So that's the Croats, Croatia,
Serbia.
And then this is where the Bosniaks, right? Bosnian Muslims in Bosnia Herzegovina.
So, and where did the genocide occur?
In here in Bosnia Herzegovina.
Yes.
Bosnia.
That was in my next one.
Okay, sorry.
So, in July 1992 to 1995, the Serbs decided they attacked the Bosniak Muslims, both Bosnians, so that's the Bosnian Muslims. And approximately 25,000 Bosniak men, women, and children were exiled from their homes. Many of the women and girls were raped, while 8,000 of the boys and men were killed. So this is Srebrenica, and in July 1995, 8,000 men, boys and men of fighting age, that being 13 to 60, were killed. The response of the international community was limited. The U.S. under President George Bush chose not to get involved, but instead recognized the independence of both Slovenia and Croatia. The U.N. responded by donating money to Serbia and also deployed its troops to protect distribution of food and medicine to injured Muslims. But the U.N. strictly prohibited its troops from interfering militarily against the Serbs. The U.N. And the United States would not take military action, so the Serbs in Bosnia freely committed genocide against Muslims. On August 30th, 1995, effective military intervention finally began as the U.S. led a massive NATO bombing in response to the killings in Srebrenica, targeting Serbian high officials positioning throughout Bosnia. Faced with the heavy NATO bombings and a string of ground losses to the Muslim Croat alliance, Serb leader Milosevic was now ready to talk peace. Terms of the agreement included partitioning Bosnia into two main portions known as the Bosnian Serb Republic and the Muslim Croat Federation. So as for reconciliation, there hasn't been much yet because this has only happened 20 years ago, so there are still many people affected by it. So right now, every year, Srebrenica holds this memorial, and behind this is a tablet where it has listed the names of the people that were killed during this genocide, but it is still yet to be completed because many of the bodies are still unidentified. So every year, they hold a peace march where many people, they walk for 3 days. That's the same path. It's like the one we did in the refugee run where you have to walk. But this is where they were seeking from asylum. They were seeking asylum from Srebrenica to Tuzla, which is another one of the six Muslim safe zones. So they walked for 3 days, which is the same path that these men, the men and boys in Srebrenica, attempted to walk. 15,000 of them attempted to do it, but out of 15,000, only 3,000 survived. Thank you.